audience tonight. Hey, welcome home! I would like to acknowledge any vet service members as well as any first responders in the audience. Thank you for your service. The run time for the show is 2 hours with no breaks. You must sit here for the full 2 hours and not get up. I'm joking. For legal reasons, I have to say that there is a intermission between Act 1 and Act 2. Let's see. Oh yes, there are concessions available in the lobby for your pleasure, so feel free to do so. There is also a 50-50 raffle. One ticket is $3, two tickets are $5. They are being sold in the lobby as well, and they will also be sold during intermission. If you win, you get half the pot of money, and the other half will go to my boss. Washrooms are available in the lobby as well. Men's, as you exit, is on the left, and unfortunately, the women's is broken, so you must go into the lobby that way, like, hallway, because I don't know. I hope a peace party got here. Let's see. Oh, yes, next, turn off all cell phones. Turn them off completely. Do not just silence them. This show depends on communication from the lovely booth to our lovely voices. So if your phone is on, it will, I repeat, it will interfere with the signal. So you won't be able to hear my lovely voice or any of my coworkers' lovely voices. Plus, this is the 80s. We didn't have cell phones back then. So why don't you just turn them off and be present with us? Speaking of being present, if you find something funny, laugh. If you find something sad, cry. If you find any emotion, express it. This is the magic and beauty of live theater. Your reaction enhances our performance. And don't tell them I said this, but my coworkers have worked really hard to put on this fantastic production. So if you bring energy, we'll bring even more energy. Ladies, gentlemen, and everyone in between, thank you so much for being here, and enjoy the show.
Well, hey there, everybody. When I hear that sound, it takes me back to a time before computers and cell phones, back when apples and blackberries were something I'd pick out behind the barn. Well, we're going back to 1979, when a gallon of gas ran you about 86 cents, shag rugs, pet rocks, and disco were the hottest things around, and it seemed like your whole life existed between the hours of 9 to 5. Back then, there was no such thing as office assistants. We were just secretaries, and the boss wasn't interested in no women's movement. Well, unless, of course, it was happening under his desk. Makes the juggling act in the circus look like a piece of cake.
Oh.
sexy, she's sweet, she's well, oh, you know who she is. Well, there's Judy. Ain't nothing simple for her right now. She don't know it, but her whole life is about to change. Heck, the whole world is about to change.
I swear to you, I'm gonna do it. Grit my teeth and I'll get through it. It's hard to see the other side when you're down.
My section. Why are they always in my section?
You're just lucky, I guess.
I'm going to need a special library just for the hat. Oh, brother. Hi, I'm Violet Musta. I'll be training you here at Consolidated.
Judy Burnley, nice to meet you. Today is quite the big day for me.
Big day, big hat.
Thank you. I left an hour early to make sure I was here in time, but the perking was impossible. Fun fact, perking meters were invented in Oklahoma City in 1935. Sorry, I should trivia when I'm nervous.
Okay. This will all be yours. Thrilling, isn't it? So let's get started with a typing test. I'm going to dictate and you type. From Franklin Hart, President, Consolidated Industries. To the employees, when planning for your retirement, why diversify? And, you know, it works a lot better with paper in the typewriter.
Oops.
Where did you say you worked before?
Well, I never really had a job in an office.
No kidding.
You're not gonna tell them, are you?
I'm gonna have to.
Yeah. Well, where was I no skills because I've spent my entire adult life taking care of a husband who just dumped me for a 19-year-old named Mindy with an eye.
All right, come on now, don't cry. So you have absolutely no office skills whatsoever.
None. Is this when you call security?
This is where I tell you I love a challenge. And welcome to Consolidated.
Oh, thank you so much. I just hope I can do the job.
Relax, you'll be fine. I've been at Consolidated for 15 years. You'll get it, and who got the very best training?
Really?
Who? Me.
Now that we're separated, I
right, way too many memories.
Hey there, who's this?
Judy Burnley, first day.
Hey there, Judy. I hope everyone's been treating you real friendly and showing you around. If there's anything I can do for you, just give me a holler, because I know what it's like to be the new girl in town.
We don't like her.
Here for you, I want you so. barbecue sauce on top of the sugar.
Mira, I had to go back to the Stone Ages and use white. That's nothing. In the old days, you made a mistake, You had to retype the entire document.
You said it, sister.
I've never come out with a new typewriter this year. With triple pitch, electronic keyboard, and wait for it, automatic right margin justification.
Ooh!
Heads up, lucky accountant's 11 o'clock.
Would believe that he's got the house for you.
Stop, I'm a widow.
Hey, just because you're not going to order doesn't mean you can't peruse the menu.
Hey, Violet.
I think I hear my typewriter calling.
Have 10 chance to carry a 6 file.
Here it is, I'll sign and seal by heart.
Girl.
You're the best. And I'm not saying that because I want you to like me. I mean, I want you to like me. But I'm not just saying that. Never mind. New subject. Can't say anything. Oh, you idiots. Well, thank God it's Friday, huh?
Woohoo!
Hey, you know what I was thinking.
Time to get back to work?
How about dinner? Tomorrow night?
I don't know. How late do your parents let you stay up?
Come on. Junior con, senior office manager. I can think of a better match.
It's the junior-senior thing that worries me. And besides, I could spend the weekend with my son.
Bring him. I am fantastic with resentful adolescent boys who think they're going to lose their mother.
Joe, I'm old enough to be your mother's sister.
I don't see you really at all.
I'll tell you what. I'll think about it.
Don't think about it. Just do it.
Just do it. That'd make a great slogan for something.
But taking losing ground instead.
it's exactly.
Oh, it's completely up my alley. I own this alley. I'll be done in a minute. Do you want to grab a bite to eat? Maybe talk?
Oh, Julia, I can't stay. Mimpy's waiting for her.
What's she doing in the car anyways? Practicing for her learner's permit? Dick? I'm sorry.
Can you believe it? Me, mother of an aging child, a widow for God's sake, and I'm still his girl?
Why'd you let him get away with it?
Because he made a decision on lunch in a few days. Until then, I'm playing the game.
Well, you need to get your mind off of work all the time and start dating.
Oh,
all the men are getting paid more than the women here. I get 12,000, but Milton gets 14,000 for doing the exact same job. Could you tell me your salaries?
Oh, no, I don't talk money, honey.
Violet! Violet!
Did you receive my memo on inflation salary information?
Yes, Raza, I tore right through it. Did you receive my memo regarding superfluous memos?
No! Wait, what? Judy Burnley, please hold. Judy Burnley, please hold. This is... Hello? Hello? Hello?
You hung up on them, didn't you?
Sure did. But I didn't cry!
Hold on.
How about getting lunch with me, Margaret?
Liquid diet.
Hey, Violet, how about you?
I'm sorry.
Hey, Judy. I was wondering if you'd like to have lunch with me today. I know the cutest little Italian spot, just hop, skip, and a jump from here.
Dorley, I'd really like to, but...
But what? Does it look like I have rabies or something?
No, it's just that...
What did they say to you about me?
Nothing. Really.
They must have said something. I'm not a fool. I can see what's going on around here.
Dorley, I'm new here. I'm just trying to go with the flow.
I've always been misunderstood. Because of how I look. But don't judge me by the cover, because I'm a real good book. So read into it what you will, but see me as I am. The way I look is just a country girl's idea of land.
Judy, we have lunch reservations for two.
I'm still the boss here, and I'm not just gonna sit here and take... goddammit! I told you to get this shirt fixed 6 weeks ago! Violet, get back to work.
I'm going. But before I go, I have one more thing to say. Don't you ever refer to me as your girl again. I am no girl, I am a woman. W-O-M-Y-N. I am not your wife, your mother, or even your mistress.
What?
I am your employee, and I expect to be treated equally with a little dignity and a little respect.
What do you mean, mistress?
Oh, come off it, Dorley. Everyone knows you and Mr. Hart are having an affair.
An affair? Who's been saying that?
Who's been saying that?
He has.
What?
Now I can explain.
You've been telling everybody that I'm sleeping with you? Well, that explains why they all treat me like some dime store floozy. They all think I'm banging the boss. You love it, don't you? It gives you some sort of cheap thrill like knocking over pencils and picking up papers.
You gain a little excited.
I have put up with your grabbing and chasing me around the desk because I need this job. But this is the last straw. I've got a gun out there in my purse. And up till now, I have been forgiving and forgetting because that is the way I was brought up. But if you say one more word about me, I will grab that gun of mine and change you from a rooster to a hen with one shot.
I think I at least deserve a sorry.
Oh, Dorothy, I am so sorry.
Not from you.
She thought you were sleeping with him too. We all did.
Well, that makes me feel a whole lot better.
Is it 5 o'clock already? Where is everyone going?
Home to get drunk.
At a girl.
Apology I ever got, but it'll do.
Can you believe he fired Maria just for discussing salaries?
Can you believe he told everybody that I was sleeping with him?
Can you believe he gave a promotion to someone I trained? What a rat!
What a liar!
What a creep!
I think I'm gonna start smoking again. I think I have a pack in here somewhere.
I don't think a cigarette's gonna make me feel better.
Bet this one will.
You roll your own?
Is that Mary Joanna?
Keep it down!
I have enough for the whole office. Well, I'm going home to forget my troubles. Anyone coming with?
A man.
Me too! Oh, hell, we'll just take the stairs.
Violet, where are you girls going in the middle of the afternoon?
Get off my back, Roz! We're taking a coffee break!
Are these real?
As real as the hair on my head.
Well,
what was the picture of?
What picture?
The one on your head!
Oh, right.
I had this picture of everyone in the office dressed like gangsters, and they were all trying to rob a heart. It was just like Fred McMurray in Double Indemnity.
It was a dark and stormy night in the city that doesn't nap. But the club was hot, and the girls were hotter. They had movie star faces and legs that went all the way from here to Pittsburgh. At least that's what Hart thought when he came crawling in out of the rain. Dressed to kill.
Literally.
Wow, God, she's sexy, I must say. I noticed you. I bet you
dance of death. Come on, sweetheart, and dance with me. I'll show you how it goes. We'll dance real fast.
I'll kick your ass.
For everyone that you propose. I'll spin you around. I'll throw you down. I'll hurt on your heart. We'll dance a bit and end like this. Stiletto in your crowd.
Oh, God.
Make a magic mixture and make him disappear.
put something in my coffee.
Unlucky her.
Oh my god!
What's wrong?
I don't know what happened.
Oh my god! My poison is
him, and then we'll decide what to do.
Doralee's right. Maybe we should all just go back to our desks and wait and see what happens.
And Violet, maintain.
Fire me for a thing like that?
Okay, you're getting hysterical. We're gonna go find.
I am so
no, I'm sorry. I can't do that.
I'm losing my circulation. Please, I'll make it up to you three, I promise. Untie me here, it's really hurting here.
Oh, Mr. Hart, I'd like to offer you my sincerest apologies. You know Dorley didn't really mean it. This is all one big mistake. But you gave me your word!
I lied. Operator? Damn it! Well, there's really something to me if I'm driving to the police.
Oh, yes, there is. Hold or I'll shoot!
Oh my God. You're as crazy as the others.
Judy, what are you doing?
I'm taking care of business.
Well, congratulations, but what are we going to do now?
I say we not come out and leave town.
You can't do that to me.
We really can't.
I poisoned him. You tied him up. You just tried to shoot him. We can't just let him go.
I have an idea. Let's just say bygones be bygones.
Don't listen to him. He lies. He lies. Just sit there and be quiet while we think.
I know one thing. We've got to get him out of this office.
I'd take him home with me, but I don't think Dwayne would go for that.
Mrs. Hart's on vacation. We could take him to his house.
Good idea.
No matter how long you three keep me here, the moment I soon get out of here, I'm going straight to the police. So you have two options. Let me loose, or kill me. Girls, I mean ladies, you're ladies, right? I don't deserve to be treated like this.
They say we always get what we deserve. Whether good, bad, or indifferent.
That's what I always heard.
No good deed goes unpunished, but the bad deeds you have done stretched out, I'm sure, that they would reach from here to kingdom come.
We think it's time you get what you
order.
We're not being ordered.
The tables are turning. Men are
$5. I gave it to him.
Well, where is he?
Well, I know he hasn't gone out to lunch yet, because his coat is still here. And look, I keep telling him how dangerous it is to leave a lit cigar.
There are pressing matters. Tell him to call me the minute you see him.
No problem, Ross. I'm sure he's just hung up somewhere.
We're gonna have to do something about her. We can't keep this up for much longer.
Has anyone ever tried to shoot her?
We've shown amazing restraint. Forget about Roz. We've got to do something about Hart.
I say we hire a bunch of wranglers to beat the shit out of him.
No, we've got to find something we can use to blackmail him. Then we make a deal. He doesn't turn us in, we don't turn him in.
What about a sex scandal? Get a picture of him in bed with a prostitute.
Hart would just buy up all the copies and send him out as Christmas cards.
There's got to be something here. Help me start looking. We can't keep him in his house forever.
I don't know about that. I never realized how unpopular Mr. Hart is.
You're right. Other than Roz, no one really wants to see him face to face.
Well, the problem is, Roz isn't going to hold that baby much longer.
Let's send her on vacation.
She can't take more than 2 weeks. It might not be enough time.
A language immersion center. There's one in Denver that you have to live at for a month. Dick was taking French once when his business was thinking of opening overseas.
Not bad. Hart writes her a memo about a major expansion. He needs executives who speak French.
Do you think she'd go?
Are you kidding? She'd off Mother Teresa if Hart asked her to. I'll just write the memo and sign it from Hart.
Bingo!
What is it?
Two sets of accounting books. Looks like Hart's been stealing from the company.
No head of a company would ever fake the books or steal from its stockholders.
The only way we'll be able to prove is if we can trace the money back to Hart.
We're gonna have to check his bank accounts for a start. Here's where faking his signature's gonna come in handy.
Violet, isn't Joe in accounting? Maybe he can help us.
No, it's possible he could even be in on this. We're going to have to handle this ourselves.
Hey, you guys, wouldn't it be funny if we posted some changes from Hart?
Why can't we?
What do you mean?
Why can't we run the office the way we want to?
Like being able to keep pictures and things on our desks?
Or like getting a whole hour for lunch?
Think bigger.
An hour and a half?
Bigger.
How about Hart never comes back and you become CEO?
Too big. It's the old boys club. I could never be CEO.
Sure you could.
No, you really could, Violet.
It would be wonderful, wouldn't it? But it's never gonna happen.
Look how far we've come already.
Come on, Violet, dream big. Anything's possible.
A female CEO. That would be something, wouldn't it? Man, I want it so much I can taste it.
to Rosalind Keith, Company Expansion, blah, blah, blah. You are hereby assigned to the Lester Language Immersion Center in Denver, Colorado, and so on and so on. Effective immediately, sign Franklin Hart. I can't be away from him, I mean, here, for an entire month. I don't speak to him immediately.
He just gave this to me on his way out. Maybe you could still catch him. Judy, do you see Mr. Hart?
Yes. Oh, Mr. Hart, wait a minute. Oh, you just missed him.
Effective immediately. Why would you do this without talking to me first?
Sorry, Roz. It's business, anything but.
As Mr. Hart always says.
As Mr. Hart always said.
I think you'll find everything you need in here.
Bon voyage.
What? What?
Better get going, Roz. It's already 5.
Yeah.
she's already feeling like a brand new woman.
Too bad there's no sexist, egotistical, lying, hypocritical bigot rehab we could send her to.
We are so good at this.
We should try to take over all regional offices.
Judy, too big.
Hey, you know, we only have a few more days until Roz gets back.
Don't worry, we'll be ready for her.
I sure hope so. Okay, I gotta go to daycare.
Again?
I can't help it, those babies are too cute!
Hey, do you know where my mom is?
Everything okay, Josh?
I'm here to pick her up. I just got my driver's license.
Congratulations! I think she's in the conference room putting in something called an answering machine.
Cool.
Lunch today, darling?
Can't today. I'm going out with my mans. How about tomorrow?
It's a date.
So cool that heart started to give you all an hour's lunch.
He's a new man, darling.
Alone so much. I can't wait till we now heart. And things are going to be different around here 24/7.
24/7? What is that supposed to mean?
I don't know. Just made it up. Shh, here comes Joe.
I never thought I'd love two days for coming to work. If I'd known better, I'd be someone else from this office.
Exactly. What are you trying to say, Joe?
Let me try again. Good morning, Violet. Dorothy. Beautiful day, isn't it?
Are you saying someone other than Hart is running this office?
Oh, what's the matter with you?
Nothing, I'm fantastic.
If you say so.
I said so. I just said it.
Dorothy, can you give us a second?
Excuse me, I got an office to run.
I've got work too.
What's going on?
Would you stop?
Come on, I know you. Something's wrong.
I'm telling you, I'm fine.
Stop pushing me away. Talking. Seriously, you can tell me anything.
We've got Hart locked up in his house while we're trying to prove he's been stealing from the company. We're trying to collect enough evidence to prove he's been cooking the books.
Not what I was expecting.
Me neither.
You actually kidnapped Mr. Hart.
No, we just sort of... Yeah, we kidnapped Hart. And if we don't find enough evidence before Ms. Hart comes back next week, we're screwed.
I have access to every financial account in this company. I bet I can help you.
Really?
See what happens when you actually talk to me.
Joe, you're the best.
I'm the best. Okay, professional. Violet, have there with me. No time to think about it. Just say yes.
Joe, I think you're a great guy.
Not that the great guy speech. Give me one good reason why you won't go out with me. That's some bull of that age. Come on, Violet. It's not like you're not already in my 30s.
Oh my God, you're still in your 30s?
What is it? Really?
I'm a one-man woman. I've had my woman.
He's been gone for over 3 years now, hasn't he?
Sometimes it seems like he was here yesterday. Sometimes it seems he's been gone a lifetime.
But don't you think it's time to find something you're looking forward to than just showing up here every day?
Thank you.
You see, you can't treat people the way you do and expect them to miss you when you're gone. It hurts me to say that to you, Mr. Hart, but honestly...
Blah, blah, blah. Can you do me a favor and shut up?
Alrighty then, nighty-night. Dick, what are you doing here? How did you know where I was?
I've been following you around for a while. Who's placing
no,
this?
No, you have to go.
You're here, aren't you?
I'm house-sitting for a friend.
How about a cup of coffee for your husband?
Ex-husband.
Technicality.
Maybe to you. I thought you were in Mexico with... what's her face?
Yeah, well, things sort of didn't work out.
She dumped you, didn't she?
There was this cliff diver... long story, not important. What was that?
Nothing. Probably just the cat. I'll go check.
The cat?
Stay here, Dick. Oh my god!
Hey, get off of me! Get...
Stay out, Dick!
Who's he?
Nothing! My boss!
Well, I didn't get rid of me!
What?
Bondage, S&M, sex games, you're into all that now?
Yep, everything, I'm into all of it. Okay, you need to go.
So typical, having an affair with your boss.
You had one with your secretary.
But now I want you back. This isn't you.
You don't know me. I've changed.
Not this much, you can't be serious.
Dick, don't tell me what I can do. If I want to have an affair, or smoke pot, or do M&M's, you can't stop me. Well, it's funny how you waltz in me. Assuming I come back. Well, let me tell you something. You are way off track. Can't you see I'm different? Or are you still that blind? No, you stand right there and take it. There's no love to hide behind. Well, I'm proud. Really doing good. I'm doing so much better.
that, right? We have enough evidence to prove Hart's been embezzling from the company.
Deposit slips, wire transfers, swollen bank accounts. More than enough to convince him to make a deal.
Congratulations, ladies. Did a phenomenal job.
Couldn't have done it without you, Joe.
Yes, you could.
Yes, we could have.
Judy!
Surprise!
Oh my God, how did you get out?
What happened?
How'd you get my gun? Judy!
Did you know that JR's mother is Mary Martin?
You think you did with that investment purchase? He did the jump on me? Did you?
No. Look at that, Mr. Carter. Got ready in serious trouble.
I thought I heard the voice of the junior accountant, but that's impossible. Because he's fired!
Hart, it's over. We have proof that you've stolen thousands and thousands of dollars from Consolidated.
Are you really going to compare a little creative accounting to what you three did to me?
Mr. Hart, can we please talk about this?
Sure, we can talk to... We have a little chat with the police. And I'll get off scot-free by hiring the best lawyer in town. And you guys could be going to jail for assault, kidnapping, and attempted murder. Didn't think this through, huh? Let's go.
Mr. Hart! It's so good to see you again.
Who are you?
Oh, you don't recognize me. I'm Margaret Palmer.
You're the old blood!
Well, I was, but thanks to Consolidated's new alcoholism rehabilitation program, I'm a new woman. I especially want to thank you for the words of encouragement you wrote me while I was in rehab. You don't know how much it means to me to have had someone else say, "Atta girl."
She was beautiful!
Right?
But rehab, what is she talking about? I never agreed to this.
Why, sure you did, Mr. Hart. Your signature is on every memo.
Every memo.
Oh, I almost forgot to mention, Mr. Tinsworthy's on his way up.
Mr. Tinsworthy's here? Now?
Who's Tinsworthy?
He's the chairman of the board.
Shit!
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 Shit! Shit!
He's your heart! Just leave!
Shit!
It's the end of the week, sir. We feel we're more productive when we're relaxed. So Mr. Hart instituted something called Casual Fridays.
Casual Fridays? I like it. But it's Thursday.
That's Mr. Hart for you. Always ahead of the curve.
I'll say. Hart, I'm dunk on what's been happening in this division over the past 4 weeks.
And I'm so glad you're here, so we can clean up this mess. There's something you need to know.
Damn right. I need to know who's responsible.
These women!
For the 20% rise in productivity.
What?
These women are responsible?
Yes, no. Violet was the ringleader here.
Is this Violet Newstead? The Violet Newstead? I've heard a lot about her.
Thank you, Mr. Tinsworthy.
What's been going on around her, Violet?
So I think we're talking about two different things.
Hart, hush. I'm talking to a lady.
Well, sir, my two colleagues, Dorley Rhodes, Judy Burnley, and I thought it was time to make some changes in the office.
We thought that with some new ideas, job sharing, flexible hours, and a daycare, we could really improve the quality of life here at Consolidated.
And increase productivity at the same time.
And Mr. Hart signed off on everything. Dorley has copies of every memo.
How many memos?
About 100.
I'm proud of you, Hart, for nurturing such creative thinking from secretaries, no less.
Oh, God, here we go.
I want you by my side, Hart. I think it's time you came to work with me.
It would be an honor.
Mr. Tinsworthy, I think you might want to look at this file first.
Before we get to that, there's something you need to know about what these three have really been up to. Sir, while I strive to make this company feel like family.
A family?
And the sacrifices I made so my girls can reach to their fullest potential.
Your girls?
Sir, while they're painting desks and hanging curtains in the Xerox room, sir, they've also been holding me-
Hostage!
Violet!
Excuse me, what?
It's no use. We might as well complain. He's going to get us anyways. But before we get arrested and spend the next 30 years in prison making pen pals in Nebraska, I have a few things to say. This place was hell until we fixed it. We do all the work of keeping things running around here the best that we can. Mr. Tinsworthy, not him. He plays golf and drinks scotch and takes all the credit. And why? Because he's the guy.
Now wait a
minute! No, you wait a minute! I've waited my whole life. You see, we're not the guy. We're just the little guy. The little guy doesn't play golf. He plays catch up. The little guy is late to picking up the kids because of work and late to getting to work because of the kids. The little guy cooks and coaches ball and balances budgets and stretches a dollar as far as it can go and works her ass off. And if that doesn't qualify for her to be heard and seen and respected, well, what does? And so yeah, we kidnapped Hart and threw him in the back of my Buick.
Tied him up like a little pig at the state fair. Strung him up with a garage door opener.
We tried to make everything better now, and he's gonna get all the credit, and we're gonna get 10 to life.
Hostage, garage door opener. Little lady, you are one hell of a joker.
Sir, they really...
I'm impressed by what's gone on here in the last few weeks. Frank, I'm promoting you all the way to the top.
Thank you, sir.
The Bolivian operation is beginning to take off. I could use a man like you.
What?
Yeah. Well, congratulations, Mr. Hart. I couldn't think of a more deserving person.
But Violet knows more about the office than I do.
Another ingenious thought. Only a visionary like you would suggest a female CEO.
No, it didn't.
That is, of course.
Yes, sir. I got it.
I would like to accompany Mr. Hart to Bolivia. I speak fluent French.
What do we need you here? We are more regretting than Violet.
I'm flattered, sir, but...
Better get packing, Frank. I got inside info that there may be a military coup down there. And you know how that could be trouble.
Sir, if we can talk about this...
I won't be taking no for an answer. Bob?
Bob?
Funny, right?
Congratulations to all three of you. You won't have to worry about Mark and Ian here again for a long, long time. Carry on.
Everybody after this. We're going to tell you. Let's start with Roz. Of course, now, Roz worked well into the 90s, though she was unable to get over the loss of her beloved Mr. Hart. Things changed when she re-met an old acquaintance on the social networking site and realized she had found her true soulmate. Oh, and Frankenhart, he was abducted by an angry tribe of Amazonian warriors and was never heard from again. Burling lived happily for the rest of her life as a strong, independent, single woman. She became a frequent guest on The View after writing her best-selling memoir, Life Without Dick. Of course, Dorothy moved on from Consolidated and followed her dream of becoming a country western singer. Dwayne had her almost talked into running for president, but she wouldn't do it because she realized too many big boobs had already been in the White House. Violet and Joe have been together for almost 30 years. Violet ran Consolidated until she came up with a little invention called the Clapper. I love that, don't you?
Yeah. been a tremendous effort. And it's all a huge team that comes together. You see about 60 students and 4 alumni helping us out in the pit. And we had all students in the booth, except I was kind of filling in rugby game today for our stage manager. It really is always bittersweet when we get to this point, because we know the value of performing arts in our lives. How many of you over the course of this production can say your lives have taken a step for the better by doing this? Next, some of you, none of them are better. It's the after parties. And to be here too early on a Sunday, I think that's what it is. No, we know how important the arts are. We thank you for supporting performing arts. We want to make sure we keep having arts classes. So those of you who are in the audience who are students or future students, make sure you sign up for those performance classes. Okay? Whether it's a drama or a choir or a band class. Okay? We have solving drama classes, including a directing class that Mr. Cohen has helped pioneer, be a leading. We have a 1X festival. Who's directing that 1X festival?
No!
Oh, the great comedians can find all the notes in drama as well. So that 1X Festival, I believe, is in 4 weeks. We have here our fearless leader, Ms. Katie Thompson. Then we have our film photographer, who's our music director. Quentin Nadig, who is our technical director. We have Kevin Harriman, conducting the pit. We have Alicia and Jackie Moon from the math department to help us with math. And we have John Cohen and Logan Jones helping us in various capacities for drama and music. If I missed anybody, I'm sure they're in the credits, so in the program, so make sure you share that with others. Let's see, we have a raffle to do, and one of the things that we like to do here on the last day is get our youngest member in the cast to help do it. I'm going to go out on a limb, I think, since she's our only freshman, Alexis. Every single day from TFA over here, so we appreciate that. Okay, split the pop raffle. We had 146 come in, so it means $73 is available. Okay, let's make sure you have your tickets out. Okay, Alexis, go ahead and pull the number. Can you go ahead and, go ahead and read that number.
0747490.
Once again, that number is
0747490.
Okay, calm down. For the next part of today, I'm going to go ahead and pass it over to Ms. Foster.
To acknowledge our seniors who will be leaving us. This is the part where people start crying. It's great, you'll love it. So, with that, we have 12 seniors in the cast. If they could please step forward. Club. they are going to be getting some roses, because we're fancy, and a book to help them through the next years of their lives, no matter where they end up, with a little inscription for me, because I'm sappy. So, first, I'm going to call your name to come up here, because we're going to do this in book order. All right?
Oh, God.
Okay.
I didn't think this through.
Johnson!
Here you go, Jonathan, and our regular Mr. Tinsworthy. Excellent. All right, next we have Oliver. Our Dick. Great job. Gwen. Thank you so much for coming. Have a wonderful day.